Welcome to New Mexico State University's Knowledge-Based Instructional Video Series. This series is brought to you by NMSU's ICT department. Throughout the year, this series will feature a number of helpful tutorials regarding NMSU-specific technological procedures, services, and software. If you have any additional questions that these videos do not address, please contact NMSU's ICT Help Desk at 575-646-1840 through email at help@nmsu.edu or in person at the Harmon Jacobs Building, room 105. For this tutorial, we will be demonstrating how to locate, download, install, and log into your web.nmsu.edu website using PuTTY from a Windows computer, and the web browser used for this tutorial is Google Chrome. PuTTY is an application that allows you to create a secure socket shell, or SSH, with the NMSU network. Connecting to the NMSU network through an SSH will allow you to upload HTML documents through a secure file transfer protocol, or SFTP program, and make customizations to your web.nmsu.edu website. Note, if you are attempting the procedures described in this video, you will need to be connected to the Aggie Air or Aggie Air WPA2 network. If you are not able to connect to one of these networks, you will need to use the Cisco VPN application. A link to the Cisco VPN instructional video can be found in this video's description. To begin this process, please open your internet browser and type www.putty.org into your search bar and press enter. Once the page has loaded, you will see three options. Click on the link next to the option found at the top entitled Download PuTTY. This link will load a page that provides links to download the PuTTY SSH source code and supporting documentation. The links that you will need are found in the first set titled Package Files. Here you will see links for both Windows 32-bit and 64-bit. If you are not sure what version of Windows you are running, please consult the documentation found in the link titled Determine What Your Computer Is Running in the description below. Once you determine what version of Windows you are running, click on the appropriate link to initiate the download. Once the download is complete, you can click on the file found in the bottom of your browser window to initiate the installer. When the installer opens, the first window will display a short message. Please review this and click Next. The next window gives you the ability to choose your destination folder. The default location is set to your program files unless you have changed this in your settings previously. If you would like to change your destination folder, do so at this time and click Next when you are ready to continue. The next window will prompt you to choose your product features. Please click Install when you are ready to continue. The installation process will initiate. At this point, you may be prompted to provide an admin username and password. Enter this information if necessary and continue. The last screen of the installer will be to finish. Click this button when you are ready to continue. Note, the README text will automatically launch when you click Finish. Review this and close the window when you are ready. To launch PuTTY, click on the Start menu and navigate to the program file named PuTTY. Here, you will need to choose the program simply entitled PuTTY. After PuTTY launches, you will need to enter the host name. In this box, enter web.nmsu.edu. You will also need to make sure the box under port is filled with the number 22. Once these fields are entered, navigate to the bottom of the window and click Open. This will launch the SSH input window. You will be prompted to log in as first. Enter your myNMSU username and press enter. Next, you will be prompted for a password. Here, you will need to enter your myNMSU password and press enter. Note, entering in your username and password is time sensitive. If you lose connection, you will need to close this window, launch the PuTTY program once again, and enter in the hostname and port. You can find links to more videos and documentation to assist you through several of the processes that were mentioned in this tutorial. Thank you for your time and patience, and we hope you found this video helpful.